The music world has lost an incredible icon this past week. Rest in peace, Prince. Everyone, J-Bone here. Yeah, it's been a few days, and doing the China tribute the other day was hard enough, and then jumping on the Wrestle Addict podcast and sharing my thoughts on China there was also difficult. So I figured I'd wait a couple days and just chill out, clear my head, and just wait and see, you know, what else was out there. Excuse me, sorry. As far as tributes, just because, you know, I could have jumped on there the day of being a total just wreck and said stuff and then, you know, realized, you know, because you think about stuff later when you have time to chill out and clear your head, you reflect, and other things come to your mind. And I'm glad I did that, because I was able to put some thoughts together. I just want to share them with you. If you're on my channel, you know I love music. I don't do a ton of music-related videos, but I do love music. You know, it's my, like, you know, wrestling and music are my two number one things, but very passionate about. I'm mainly a metalhead, but growing up, you know, I listened to a lot of different stuff. Everything from, you know, the crooners, like, you know, my parents introduced me to, like, you know, Sammy Davis, Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, you know, those guys, you know, like the Rat Pack guys, you know, that kind of jazzy, you know, sound, you know, that was a big influence on some of my youth. And then as I got older, I got into the pop stuff. I live right outside of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, so if you're from around here, you'll know the the call letters, you know, like 94 WKTI. They played the top 40 pop rock stuff. You know, and back when I was little, it was, you know, it was Duran Duran, it was Michael Jackson, it was Prince, it was Madonna. You listened to all that stuff. Well, I did. You know, not everybody listened to that, but I did. And I remember opening up Milwaukee Journal or Sentinel or whatever it was at the time, back in the 80s. And it was like an entertainment page or whatever. Featured article. On one side of the page was a long picture of Michael Jackson. The other side was a long picture of Prince. And I remember cutting that out and putting it up on my wall, because that was like the big rivalry back then. You were either a Michael Jackson fan or you were a Prince fan. And it made you feel like this art, reading this article made you feel like you had to pick one. But I couldn't pick one. I've loved music since little on. I've loved all sorts of stuff. I remember going over to a friend's house and seeing the movie Purple Rain for the first time. And it was so cool. It just, I don't know. And by the way, this is my sad attempt at a Prince shirt. It's my Macho Man shirt. It's purple. So I was like, okay, I gotta wear something purple. back to my youth. But yeah, I did all the, you know, Purple Rain, Little Red Corvette, you know, and then Raspberry Beret, and then later on, as I was in around the high school years, he he changed his stuff a little bit and became the new power generation. Just looking at my phone again, a notification. And I'm going to get to that in a second. tell you what it's about. The more very, like, varies. I mean, he always had some kind of, like, sleaze in his music or some, you know, something about relationships or women or something, you know. I remember being in high school and listening to Get Off. And I was like, oh, man, that's just nasty, you know. But I love the music. It was so naughty at the time, you know. And you know, things got more edgy. A lot of stuff got more edgy around that time. It was like Madonna got more edgy around that time, did more controversial things. What else did he do? Oh, Diamonds. I remember listening to Diamonds and Pearls all the time. One of my favorite Bruce Willis movies, I was just watching the other day, The Last Boy Scout. He and Damon Wayans were in the club, and now I'm going to forget her name. Damn it. Don't grow old. It sucks. You forget shit all the time. Halle Berry. There. Halle Berry was a stripper, and she was dancing in the club, and she's with Damon Wayans, and Bruce Willis is in the corner. He's like guarding her. If you watch the movie, you know what I'm talking about. And the DJ turns on Prince. And Prince is playing in the background. Oh, no, she wasn't dancing to it, but it was on in the background. Prince's Get Off, you know, and it was like, I was watching that movie the other day, and I was singing about Prince and stuff, and I was like, oh, man, that was a jam back then. And then a few days later, we get the death of Prince. And then years later, you know, and he was one of those guys where, yeah, I didn't follow him all the time, but he was always doing something. I looked up today, and I was just listening to a tribute right before I did this. Nikki Sixx, I don't know if it was on his radio show, but it's on his Sixth Sense website. Talking about, you know, if you're not sure how much music he did, he put out 39 albums. That's crazy for a career. For 57 years old and starting back in the 70s, I think. Late 70s, I think, is when he started his music career-ish, around then. Man, that's just a crazy amount of music. And then, and hearing stuff over the last few days and realizing that he has this vault and he had stuff set up in his home. He'd be recording stuff. He could be taking a dump in the bathroom and record stuff. His whole house was set up so that he could record stuff on a whim if he had an idea. So he has this vault of music that we have never even heard before. And I hope through his publicists and managers and whoever, and I'm sure somebody's going to make a pretty penny off of this, but that's that's besides the point. I hope someday that we get to hear that. It'd be a shame if fans someday couldn't hear, you know, and that we don't have to hear everything, but to hear the stuff that's, you know, that should have seen the light of day and never did. And he tucked it away somewhere so that it was safe. And it's like, well, it deserves to be heard, you know? And if you agree with me, put it in the comments below. Let me hear what you have to say. I would love to hear what you think, you know, if you're a fan of Prince. And it wasn't just his older stuff. Now, granted, I didn't listen to his newer stuff as often, but I did become a fan of his again, and I'll try to keep this quick as possible. There's a local band by the name of Bellevue Suite. And when I got together with my girlfriend you know, I told her, I'm like, I don't go see a lot of local bands, but this is a band I really like. So we went to go see Bellevue Suite at a local bar in Waukesha, not too far from here. Excuse me. And we're listening to them, and there's, I don't know, 50 people in there. It wasn't a big crowd. But man, their band was always tight. You know, even dating back to Michael Sohn's different versions of it throughout the 2000s and stuff like that. Even when he opened up for Twisted Sister and stuff like that. Tight ass band. And I hadn't seen his band live in a few years. I saw him back in 2009, right after I got divorced. And then I saw him just a few years ago. I saw Bellevue Suite a few years ago. And I'm there with my wife, and we start hearing little things, people talking about their drummer. And then they were talking about how it was, the drummer at the time was Hannah Ford. Now Hannah Welton, she got married right after that. This drummer, Hannah, this girl, mind completely blown. Okay, some of my favorite drummers of all time, like Tommy Lee and guys like that, I put her up there. This woman is talented as hell. And this was her last concert with them, and she got to do a great solo and stuff, and she just completely blew our minds that night, her last night. And, you know, honestly, it's sad that it was the only time that I ever saw her play live, but it still made that much of an impression. My wife Tracy and I got to talk to her after a show, and their manager or someone was there, and I was like, yeah, I'd love to get a picture of the band and have the band sign it. So I don't have it up around here. It's tucked away someplace. I'll put it up around here later sometime because it's special. I got the whole band to sign the 8x10. And we got to talk to Hannah. And finding out that they're moving down to Atlanta and they're working on Joshua's, her soon-to-be husband, now husband, Joshua's solo career and stuff like that. And he's a producer and they're working on stuff together. So it was just great meeting her. And we started following her, you know, seeing what projects she was working on. Not long after that, we heard that she had an announcement. And we were like, oh, what's this big announcement? We find out that Hannah, and I'm not sure, where are you going with this? Here we go. Hannah became Prince's drummer in his new all-girl band, Third Eye Girl, I think that's what it was called. And I'm sorry I'm not familiar with the other girls in the band. I did listen to it that much. But Hannah became Prince's new drummer. And we were like, oh my God, you're Prince's drummer? Are you freaking kidding me? That's... Okay, seriously, it does not get much bigger than that. That to play in a band or for, you know, an icon of that stature. So, of course, we, being proud of someone local from around here in the Chicago area like Hannah, started really paying attention to Prince's music, you know, and when we'd hear something, we'd be like, oh, hey, that's Hannah, you know. We'd see performances of Prince on TV, and there's Hannah in the background kicking ass on drums. We're so proud of you. We started, you know, following. My wife is, I think, friends with her. I follow her fan page and stuff like that. And to Hannah's family, if you do end up watching this, our prayers and thoughts go out to you and your family and your father, your manager, Dave Ford. I know you're all very close with Prince. You know, my condolences. And my condolences go out to all the family of Prince and all that too as well. So yeah, we started, you know, listening to Prince a lot more, and his sound became more almost like rocking, you know. And I haven't had a chance to listen to His latest stuff that came out within the last year, it certainly is on my to-do list. Now, but yeah, you know, it's so sad. He was like in the process of reinventing himself again over the course of the last few years with this new band with Hannah and the other girls and everything. He'd be on their solo album and they would be on his, and just this whole new batch of music was just incredible. It's so sad. So, and the tributes out there, if you haven't seen some of these tributes that I've seen, please do yourself a favor and go check them out. Corey Taylor, and you're like, Corey Taylor? Sorry. Corey Taylor of Slipknot. He's on his solo tour promoting his book or something, and he plays stuff acoustically. He did a couple of Prince songs acoustically. I believe he did was it Purple Rain? I think it was Purple Rain, and did something else. I saw a video of. Oh, if you go to Corey Taylor's Facebook page, you'll see it. It's on there, the performance. He did it live, and he posted it. It was Howard Stern's birthday show, and it just got posted. It was from a couple years ago, I think. I'd have to go look. Find out exactly when the performance is, but the video got posted just a couple days ago, so maybe he reposted it from a few years ago. Maybe that's what it was. It was Adam Levine playing with the band Train, and they played I think they played Purple Rain on there too, and man, gave me a whole new respect for Train and Adam Levine jamming on this song. The solo on there is just blistering, holy crap. And, what I was saying earlier, saw this earlier today, the band called Citizens Unite, they did an acoustic recording of Dove's Cry, haunting, incredible tribute to Prince, and we're just going back and forth on Twitter there. That's what that was. Just small talk and just saying how incredible it was. Shout out to Citizens Unite. Go check them out. Cool hard rock band I just started listening to recently. Started following them. so many tributes. What was one I saw? Oh, I saw Elton John just did. I'm not a big Elton John fan, but it's pretty cool. Did a tribute. Trying to think of any others I saw. I know I've seen a couple. But, just sad. Another icon gone. And way too soon. She's 57. And I'm not going to start talking about, there's controversy out there and why he died and how he died. I know he was sick. You know, I don't know the whole story, so I'm not even going to start, maybe it was this or maybe it was this. I'm not going to get into that. It's about remembering the music and the legacy and how many people he inspired. I was watching another video today about all the songs that are out there that either he was a part of, or he wrote secretly as another, like, character, persona, you know, under a different name. So many out there. It's unbelievable how many careers he influenced, touched, inspired. So rest in peace, Prince. certainly one of the bigger names to come out of the Midwest. I'm a Wisconsin guy, so I appreciate that kind of stuff, you know, because everything you used to hear about was either, the Seattle scene or the L.A. scene or the New York scene. Well, this is the Midwest, folks, and this center of the country, this world, has lost a very special musical icon. So rest in peace, Prince. I and your millions and millions and millions of fans love and miss you.